A very pleasant good morning to all my dear students. Students, hope you are doing your homework and reading the chapter. Okay, so welcome back for the today's class. Today we are starting our chapter with the part 3. Yes, chapter 1, part 3, history of computer. As you all already know that I am your computer teacher and I am taking your computer subject. So today we will start our class with chapter 1, part 3, and what is the chapter's name? History of computer. Okay. Now students, you have to take out your computer textbook. Okay. And in that you have to open page number 6. Right. On page number 6 you can see this topic, that is Mark 1 computer. Okay, so before starting this topic, okay, let us just revise what we have done till part 2, right? We have understand about the Abacus, then, yes, Napier's Cones, and then Pascaline, then the last topic was the analytical engine, right? So, up to that, we have completed. Now, we will continue with the part 3, and the first topic is Mark 1 computer, yes. Howard Eiffel. How do we pronounce that? Howard Eiffel, an American scientist, developed the big room size calculating machine in 1944. Right, my dear students, see here in this picture, you can also see from your textbook that this is a like device used for calculating, which used a big room. Yes, it needs a big room, and this was developed by Howard Eiffel in the year 1944. Yes, he was an American scientist and he developed this machine in the year 1944. Okay, so this machine, that's why it's known as Mark 1, right? This machine used to call Mark 1. Around 765,000 components were used to build Mark 1. Now, in this, my dear students, small parts, okay, chote parts, jo use hote hain, that are the components. Around 765,000 were used to build this. Isko banane ke liye 765,000 components ki zarurat padti thi. Okay, so long wires that measured up to thousands of kilometers were used in it. Long wires that measured up to thousands of kilometers were used. Yani itni lambi lambi wire use ki jati thi, jo kitni hoti thi, around thousands of kilometers, itni badi hoti thi, and it weighed more than 4500 kilos, and their weight was more than 4500 kilos. This was the first programmable computer, right? So this computer was the first one to program. Okay, Miss Grace Hopper was the first lady to write programs for Mark 1 computer. Miss Grace Hopper was the first lady to write programs for Mark 1 computer. Now, before inventing this machine, right, Miss Grace Hopper was the first one to write programs. Programs bhi likhne hote hain computer mein before making that. Okay, so she was the first lady to write program for this Mark 1 computer. Now students, let's see who was Howard Eiffel. Yes, here in the picture you can see he is the Howard Eiffel. He was the first one to develop Mark 1 computer. And let's see the clear picture of this. Yes, this is the clear picture. See, pure room ko cover kiya hai, right? So in this, different components were used, long wires were used. They were weighing more than 4500 kilos, right? See, pura room cover kiya hai, right? Okay, now let's see Miss Hopper. See, Grace Murray Hopper. Yes, she was the first one to write programs. Mark 1 computer ko banane ke liye usko program kaise karna hai, usme kaun se programs chalenge. She was the first one to write down all the programs. Okay, and she used to be in the American Army also. Yes, here you can see, dekho, she has wore the uniform also, right? So, this was about the Mark 1 computer. Now, we will continue with the... Yes. So, on page number 7, we are continuing with the topic ENIAC. Okay, so now let's see what is the full form of this ENIAC. Okay, how do we pronounce फॉर्म है. लेट्स सी द फुल फॉर्म. इलेक्ट्रॉनिक न्यूमेरिकल इंटीग्रेटर एंड कैलकुलेटर. इलेक्ट्रॉनिक न्यूमेरिकल इंटीग्रेटर एंड कैलकुलेटर. द ENIAC वॉज डेवलप्ड बाय जॉन मॉशली एंड जेपी एकर एट द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ पेनिसिल्वेनिया इन 1946. ओके, लेट अस रीड आउट वंस अगेन. द ENIAC वॉज डेवलप्ड बाय जॉन मॉशली एंड जेपी एकर एट द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ पेनिसिल्वेनिया इन 1946. So this ENIAC, right? This was developed by the two persons, and who are they? John Moshley and J.P. Eckert, and they developed this at the University of Pennsylvania in 1946. Okay, ENIAC was first digital computer of world. Okay, so this ENIAC was the first digital computer in the world. Okay, the expense to make ENIAC was more than $5 million at that time. So during that time, in 1946, to develop this digital computer, how much expense was there? More than $5 million. The approximate numbers of different components used to make ENIAC are mentioned here. So for this digital computer, it was the first digital computer of the world, right? And to make this, many more components were used, right? So these are the components which are mentioned here. We will see what are the components used to make this digital computer. Okay, so first of all, we will understand this three lines, and then after that I'll show you the picture of John Moshley and J.P. Eckert, right? And with that we will see about this different components. Okay, so how many components were used? Here are mainly five. Okay, five diye gaye hain components. Isse zyada bhi use hue the. But mainly vacuum tubes were used 18,000. Yes, and diodes were used 7,000. Resistors were used like 70,000. Capacitors 10,000 and switches 60,000. Yes, my dear students, it was like the expense was more than $5 million. Okay, so the components are also in a big amount. Okay, see, vacuum tubes 18,000, diodes 7,000, resistors 70,000, capacitors 10,000, switches 60,000. Yes, so many water coolers were used to cool down the heat generated by thousands of components used by ENIAC. Now see, more than 1,000 components are there, so probably it will generate more heat. Okay, so for that they were using the water coolers. Many water coolers they were using to cool down these components. Okay, ENIAC was able to do around 5,000 addition, subtraction or 350 multiplication division in a second. Okay, so now here, like this device used to solve 5,000 addition subtraction within a second, or else it can do 350 multiplication division in a second. Yes, my dear students, this ENIAC used to solve the multiplication division around 350 in a second and addition around 5,000. Okay, addition or subtraction. Okay, so now let's see the pictures of, yes, see, he is J.P. Eckert and he is John Moshley. Yes, they both invented this ENIAC. Okay, see, now here in the picture you can see a small medal. Yes, this is the picture of them getting an award. Okay, now let's see the components. So first one, yes, here vacuum tubes were used around 18,000. So my dear students, see, these are the vacuum tubes. Different size and shapes are there of the vacuum tubes. In the same way, let's see, yes, these are the diodes. Okay, see, in the picture you can see, yes, itne chote chote small parts use hote hain. Okay, they are called the components also. So these are the diodes and they were used around 7,000. See, this is the resistors. Okay, see, and they were used around 70,000. Okay, Diodes 7000, resistors 70,000. Now, these are the capacitors. Yes, these are the capacitors. Now, my dear students, in our today's world, right? In this generation, many more capacitors are there. For the fan, it is different. For the AC, it is different. Okay, like that, many capacitors are there. But during at that time, capacitors were like this and it was around 10,000, right? Now, switches. Okay, switches were around 60,000. As you can see here, such type of switches were used. Okay, not that switch, on and off karne wala nahi. This kind of switches were used. Okay, so mainly we have seen the five components and the picture of each and every one I have shown you here. Okay. So, I hope you all have understood about the Mark 1 computer and the ENIAC. Yes, only two topics we have covered today. Okay, as it is a lengthy topic. Okay, my dear students. So, this you have to read out from your computer textbook. And those who don't have computer textbook, bacha, you can read out from the attached PDF. Okay, have a nice day.